G'day, I'm Glenn Morris from the Smart Energy Lab, and today, here on day two at All Energy, I'm with Gus from REC. Hi, Gus.
Hi, hello, Glenn. How are you? Welcome.
I'm glad I got you in the end. We've been crossing paths all day, well, missing each other all day, but finally here in front of this awesome panel, which we'll talk about in a second. But first, maybe some of the audience haven't heard much about REC. How would you introduce the company?
Well, REC is a pioneer in the solar energy industry. REC was founded in 1996 in Norway, and so it has been around for 25 years now, which is longer than the warranties we offer. So that's something quite unique in our industry. We do manufacture panels in Singapore, so we are Norway founded, but now we are based in Singapore. So all products coming to Australia and going all around the world is made very close to where we are. Also, REC is a world winner manufacturer. It won several InterSolar awards, which are the biggest recognition for innovation in solar. The latest two awards were in 2020 and 2022, and were the predecessors of this beautiful panel, the Alpha Pure series, because of the advanced technology that we are bringing to the market. And just finally, REC is also very into sustainability, and many of the cells and wafers we produce, they have the lowest carbon emission for solar panels around the world. Also, the panels that we are bringing now, some of them are lead-free, like this one, which is an evolution in solar technology. So
lead-free.
Lead-free, yeah.
Wow.
So
okay.
This is lead-free. So this is about REC. If people would like to learn more, obviously they can jump into our website. But I believe that's enough for introduction.
I'll put a link in the description below to the website. But I've also done an interview with Chun, a technical interview about these panels in particular. So I'll link that up in the card. But just getting to the technical side of these panels, they're very unique looking. There's not the usual tabs and bus bars. How do you do that?
Yeah, so that's a different way of manufacturing the solar panels. First of all, the cells are new. It's a G12. So you can see this is a full cell splitting half.
Yep.
So it's a half cut gapless technology. So we, other than having no bus bars, we have other advancements in this. But to be able to get to that, we design a cell that is flexible. So I might show you the cell.
Yes. Wow, that's just the cell.
That's just the cell. And as you can see, it's all 3D printed. And what we do with the wiring, we just lay the wiring on top of the cells, and then there is a very thin material that goes on top that is transparent, and apply some very light heat on top, and that helps to connect the wiring into the cell. So that's how we eliminated the lead component, because there is no soldering in this panel. By eliminating the lead, we also make this panel more resistant, because there is a lower chance of a potential micro crack or potentially cracking the connectors on the cell. So it's a very, very different manufacturing process.
It's more like a printing process.
It's a printing process.
It is a printing process.
Yeah, you can actually touch and you can flex that. And you see, if you do that with a normal wafer,
tink.
Yeah, you'd break with this one. Obviously, is something that is much, much more resistant, much more reliable, and that's something very unique that is not easy to find.
So, what type of silicon cell is this?
So, this is a combination. It's a hybrid cell, which is a combination of N-type cells with layers of thin film on top and below. So it's a bifacial cell.
Oh,
it's
right.
A bifacial hybrid cell.
Yes.
Heterojunction technology, which is one of the versions of N-type. Some people believe is the most evolved version of N-type, because you are then eliminating the soldering on the cells, you are eliminating the bus bars, you are eliminating most of the heat you apply to the cell. So quite technical stuff, but what you are doing that process is creating a cell that is much more resistant. You are not damaging the cell in the manufacturing process. And what it will deliver is a better performance under tough conditions, such as low light or or high heat, for example.
So with the heterojunction technology, are you getting a low temperature coefficient?
That's another benefit. So one of the benefits is the low temperature coefficient. Then what you have is on a, let's say a 25 degrees day when the panel will be reaching 50 degrees Celsius, you probably will retain another 20, 30 watts of the peak power output of the panel through the day. If you compound that over 25 years, there is a substantial amount of energy generated just on that particular feature.
I'm getting the message that quality is one of your key factors or key objectives.
Yeah.
Why would you say quality matters for a solar panel?
Yeah, I would say quality is quality just in a built product. We could translate that into the reliability of the technology and how resistant it's going to be. So that could be seen as one way of translating quality. The other way would be performance, quality in terms of performance. When you are manufacturing a cell that you are applying a newer technology that doesn't damage the cell in the first place and allows those cells to convert a wider spectrum of light, you are translating quality into high performance as well. So just to put the quality into some subcategories, I would say performance and reliability are the two key factors that differentiate these products. But also, I think there is another step that REC has gone further here, where in 2015, REC created the Twin Peak design, which was an InterSolar award winner, so an innovator. And now REC has gone a little bit further and divided this panel into four sections. So you have another layer of quality here, where you have innovation in terms of managing potential shade on a roof. So if you had shading on this section of the panel, those three other parts of the panel are still in full operation.
All right, so the short side is bypassed. So when you get shading on the short, which is the most common shading issue, near a chimney or a small wall, it'll be the low sides. Whereas conventional methodology is vertical sections.
And three bypass diodes, where here you have four. In fact, we can turn this panel around and show the junction boxes.
All right.
So as everyone can see, so those are the junction boxes, and it's a new design where you have four junction boxes. You have, for the technical installer, there is a quite long lead here, 1.7 meters. So to ensure that the cable management is going to be done in the right way, to ensure that the cable is not going to be hanging under the panel or it's not going to be over bent.
So you can reach the rails that you're going to support the cables on. And
correct.
Each of these contain the bypass diodes?
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. And you've also got these center struts here.
And yeah, and talking about panel resistance, so then you you create a higher wind load on the panel. So you, first of all, by applying this, we've been able to reduce the thickness of the panel. So if you look at this panel, it's a 30 millimeter frame. By applying the supporting bars at the back, which is an innovation as well, you increase the wind loads. So the wind load, the front load is 7,000 Pascals.
7,000?
Yeah.
That must be industry leading.
Yeah, it is industry leading. And the rear load is 4,000 Pascals. We are doing some testing for the Northern Territory now, and we are sure that's going to be even greater. So this is a cyclone tested panel for those regions.
So they're climate change resistant.
They are climate change resistant, we could put it in that way. So yeah, so as you can see, there is a lot more than just wattage on a panel. We know that recently, you know, the race to the highest wattage, was kind of never ending. What REC did is REC decided to make a panel better, not just bigger. You know,
so it's a manageable size still. They're big but manageable. They're rigid because of the center struts. They've got a long life. What's the warranty on this product?
So the product warranty is 25 years for REC approved installers.
Yep.
The normal product warranty is 20 years.
Yep.
The performance warranty is 25 years and is a leading performance warranty at 92% degradation at 92% performance over 25 years.
At 25 years?
At 25 years.
Wow, that is really amazing, because you know, mostly it's 80% and linear. So, wow. What about performance-induced, or potential-induced degradation, or light-induced degradation?
So, because of the N-type cells and the way those cells are made, those panels do not suffer light-induced degradation. So, in fact, the 92% potential degradation on the panel is an indicative degradation. Is a common understanding that high-end N-type technology will degrade between 0.25% to 0.3% on a linear degradation. So even year one, you wouldn't see much degradation.
Yeah.
So you could even expect to have potentially 95% of the initial power output on this panel. Potential reduced degradation is something that N-type also has been able to manage and overcome. So it's another benefit of having a panel like this on a roof is the certainty of energy generation and reliability. Obviously, we would guarantee a panel replacement in the event of a panel, you know, early life, if the panel would have an early life degradation. But over those 25 years, RSC was one of the companies that had the lowest warranty claims per panel.
Wow.
Which is roughly, let's call 50 panels per million. So somewhere in Australia, maybe we'd have, you know, a handful of panels coming back on a year after selling hundreds of thousands of panels. So it's a warranty the customer is unlikely to use. But also in the warranty, we offer to the approved installer the labor component on the warranty in the event of a potential failure. So we would pay the installer to go back to site, replace the panel, would supply a new panel, and that would cover all their expenses, meaning the end customer would have completely peace of mind. And that warranties for systems up to 25 kilowatts, for systems under 25 kilowatts, above 25 kilowatts, then the labor component on the warranty is 10 years.
Right. I can see that investing in REC with the commitment to quality, longevity is actually in the customer's interest in terms of return on their investment. They're going to have this system working after 25 years, still at 92%.
Yes.
And considering that solar panels had such a long life, you don't want to just go for the cheapest price, because it's not going to give you that return on your investment, is it?
No. In fact, you know, there is that say, you get what you pay for.
Mm.
And here, we truly believe that just by getting a panel that has a lower degradation and a better performance, temperature coefficiency, those factors itself will pay for the additional cost a customer will pay up front, will return much more kilowatts hour than the initial cost. So in fact, I believe that this is the cheapest investment a customer can make over a system lifetime.
Well, Gus, I'm looking forward to having some of these on my roof, and I think we're going to do that. So I'll probably link that up here when we do that little installation.
Sounds great. Sounds great. Look forward to seeing that.
Okay. Thanks, Gus.
Thank you.
Okay. See you.